sold out crowd. Razorbacks have been on the road a lot lately. Finally, they're back home. And this is a first in SEC history. The first time that four top 10 teams have been in action against each other. Of course, the other one is LSU and Alabama, starting a little bit later in Tuscaloosa. As you take a look at the standings in the SEC, the importance of this game magnified by the fact that South Carolina's already beaten Georgia. They control their own destiny in the SEC East as they try to get back to Atlanta. And Arkansas still with a shot in the SEC West. Welcome, everybody. Brad Nessler along with Todd Blackledge. Partner, all week long, let's face it, everybody said, you guys are doing that other SEC game. And that's what these players have been told all week long, too. But it is a very important game to these two programs. And South Carolina's got that opportunity to get back to Atlanta. They just got to win out.
Yeah, that's all they have to do. And, you know, it's interesting. You would never think Steve Spurrier would ever fly under the radar. But that's what he's doing with this team this year. He's done a great job of managing this team when they lost their starting quarterback, Steven Garcia, when he dismissed him. They lost their best player, Marcus Lattimore, to a knee injury. They're winning with defense. And right after Alabama and LSU in the statistical categories of total defense and scoring defense is this group from South Carolina. But they will get challenged tonight because this Arkansas offense, particularly their pass offense, is the best they've seen all year.
Well, this is a situation sort of like you and Holly and I saw last year. Yeah. Here's Arkansas at 7-1. They got a chance to get to the BCS. All they have to do is win out.
Yeah, it's interesting. I think they are hitting their stride, maybe not as much as they did at this time a year ago. The biggest thing they have to change, I think, in this game and down the stretch, they can't get behind as quickly in games as they have already this year. They've dodged the bullet a couple times with double-digit deficits. That won't get it done tonight.
Well, it is a windy night, we can tell you that much, in Fayetteville. 54 degrees, gusts at times to 20 miles an hour, and that could raise havoc with the kicking game tonight. South Carolina won the toss. They deferred, so they'll be kicking off. Wooten will tee it up, and Arkansas will have a crack at it offensively to start the ball game. Dennis Johnson, the all-time SEC kickoff return leader, active kickoff return leader, is back. There he is, number 33. Keontae Miner is there with him. So two teams that have only one loss each and thinking big things still in the SEC race underway in Fayetteville. Miner from the five. Miner, nice return out across the 30-yard line. Give it to him at the 32 and a 28-yard kickoff return. As the Razorbacks take the field, let's check our impact players. Brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Dennis Johnson, we just talked about him, not only a great return man, but he's their leader in the backfield as far as a rusher and a receiver. Jarius Wright has had a huge year, close to becoming the all-time reception leader here in Fayetteville. And Jerry Franklin, if it wasn't for Jerry Franklin, they wouldn't be 7-1. He had a 94-yard kickoff, or fumble return, I should say, for a touchdown that saved the day in Nashville last week. And here is Johnson, straight up the middle for 9 to open things up.
Well, the thing that makes Arkansas most dangerous offensively is when they've got balance. And when they have that going, when their run game gets established, to go with what they can do throwing the football and Bobby Petrino calling plays, they are really tough to defend.
On second and a yard, Johnson's got the yard and a couple more. Devontae Holloman made the stop defensively, but Arkansas already out to the 45-yard line. Tyler Wilson, he's taken a beating, taken a licking, and kept on ticking, I think, has been his thing all season long. He's been knocked around, but there's his numbers, leading the SEC with over 2,300 yards in the air.
Yeah, he certainly has proven his toughness this year, no question. And he can make all the throws you need a quarterback to make to be very proficient in the passing game.
Empty backfield right here. First down for the Razorbacks. Wilson flushed out of the pocket, looking to throw on the run, and incomplete. Jarius Wright was there.
And that what you saw right there is going to be the key for South Carolina tonight, is can they make Tyler Wilson uncomfortable? Can they make him move in the pocket and not just be able to set and throw on rhythm? When we were here a few weeks ago, he had one point where he completed 19 passes in a row.
Right.
You can't allow him to be comfortable throwing the football.
Broderick Green is back healthy, and they're going to use him a lot tonight. He is the tailback right now for Arkansas on second down at 10. And he'll get the carry. behind the fullback. Only got a couple. It's a tough wall to run against in South Carolina. Todd said it in the open. They're opportunistic. They have 16 sacks, 16 interceptions. They're a tough group, and they've got about eight guys they rotate on that front four.
Right here is going to be one of the challenges for South Carolina tonight. One of their best players on their entire defense, Antonio Allen, their spur, is not playing tonight because of a neck injury. It's him on the sidelines, and he is a big loss, a big-time player for them.
Third down at eight. Wilson, here comes the pressure. Got rid of it, and he found his open man. It's going to be a first down throw, and Greg is still heading in the Gamecocks' direction. 23 yards. That time the pressure was there, but Wilson stepped up in the pocket and delivered a wobbly pass to his tight end.
What you want to see your quarterback do is feel pressure but keep his eyes downfield. He knows there's pressure, and he doesn't take his eyes off the field. He finds Greg in the middle of the field for a big-time completion. That's good poise under pressure by Tyler Wilson.
Well, they moved it all the way to the 30-yard line of South Carolina here on the opening drive. Play action. Wilson might want it all here. Good job in the secondary by South Carolina. He's just got to throw it, and he completed it anyway inside the 10 to Hamilton. And a flag down at the end of the play. Another 23-yard pickup.
Illegal touching. Number 11 of the offense. Went out of bounds on his own. Return was first to touch. Ball is put to this previous spot. Second down.
And Matt Moore answers Todd's question. There he steps out at about the four and then comes back to make the catch. Field judge was right on top of it. So good call, and negates what would have been first and goal. As it is, second down. Back at the 30-yard line. And a pistol set this time. Wilson set to throw again. And way high. Sailed one that time. Greg Childs, the intended receiver.
I don't think Greg Childs thought he was the intended receiver because he never put his arms up for the catch. I think he thought it was intended for somebody beyond him because the ball kind of sailed on Wilson. Watch Greg Childs get into his route and doesn't even put his hands up. He thought it was for somebody behind him.
So third and long again. They converted on a third and eight.
And South Carolina likes to get pressure with four guys rushing. They're not a big blitz team.
Showed a blitz and backed out of it. And here's a quick opening draw for Broderick Green, but it doesn't pick up the first down. Nice job by Byron McKnight.
Zach Hocker was 3 for 3 a week ago against Vanderbilt. Had a 50-yarder, and then he had the 42-yarder, which ultimately was the game-winning field goal.
He had a 36 in that mix as well. There's his numbers. This one's going to be into the wind, a swirling wind here at Razorback Stadium. Hocker to try to put the Hogs on the board. Kick out of the way, and he's got it. So the opening drives. Razorbacks get three out of it with 11:33 remaining. First quarter, South Carolina will get it when we come back. Coach Petrino, part of the official groundbreaking ceremony of the new University of Arkansas Football Center, took place yesterday. New $28 million facility. They have the locker rooms, the meeting rooms, the training rooms, equipment room, student-athlete lounge. You name it, it'll be in there. It'll be something spectacular here on the campus in Fayetteville. Well, the old ball coach's team has trailed in every game this year. That's the same story here with the field goal by Hocker, 3-0.
Yeah, right in his wheelhouse.
Yep.
You know, they win. They just don't score first.
He was pretty happy, though. I think it was a field goal instead of a touchdown on that last drive. Hocker will kick. Swearinger and Stephon Gilmore back deep for the Gamecocks. And this one deep and out of the back of the end zone. Let's check in with a third member of our team, Holly Rowe. Holly?
Hey, guys, keep in mind that there are swirling winds down on the field tonight. I saw coaches from both teams show some concern in pregame about it. Zach Hawker, the kicker of Arkansas, told me that you can't look at the flags on the top of the stadium because they'll mislead you. But it didn't seem to affect him on that last field goal. Another thing to keep in mind for South Carolina, they will be without their best defensive player tonight. Antonio Allen, their spur hybrid linebacker safety position, is out. He leads the team, guys, with 62 tackles. That's nearly 20 more than anybody else on the team. The coaches say him not playing is a huge deal, particularly on third down, which we saw Arkansas convert.
No doubt about that. Kenny Miles in the backfield with Connor Shaw. Here comes a blitz off the corner. Shaw wants to throw that way and does, and diving attempt, but Sanders can't hold it. This is a different Steve Spurrier than the guy back in Florida when he won a national championship and had Danny Werfel throwing it all over the place, 344 passing yards. And Todd, you said they're doing it a lot of different ways, mostly with running the ball, defense, and making turnovers.
Well, and, you know, I thought it was interesting, too, this week. He said, you know, I don't come off the field smiling as big as I used to when we were scoring all kind of points, and but we're winning.
Yeah.
You know, we're finding ways to win. It's just different.
And he said, I guess I just can't coach four quarterbacks anymore. Doing a pretty good job, Steve. Chance to be SEC East champions again. Here is his quarterback, Shaw. Flushed. And he'll keep it and gets collared, and I mean collared, by Jerry Franklin after a two-yard pickup.
A very late flag from the field judge on the opposite side as well.
If you haven't noticed, Connor Shaw wears a glove on his throwing hand, his right hand.
Personal foul. Number 9 of the defense. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Elton Ford with the personal foul. So an automatic first down, and that's the biggest boost for the South Carolina offense of the night.
Well, the flag came in from way on the other side of the play in the secondary.
Ooh.
He took a shot at Alshon Jeffrey.
Yeah, sure
did. You know, Alshon's a big guy, so you're going to see him in the middle of the field, and Elton Ford, not a very good decision there.
And Willie Robinson, the defensive coordinator, letting him know about it on the sideline. First down, Gamecocks. Kenny Miles spins his way for four. Alonzo Highsmith, the outside linebacker, there to make the stop.
Kenny Miles has been in this program for a while. He's, you know, had moments when he's really played well. He had a wrist injury earlier this year, and that's part of the reason why Brandon Wilds kind of had to emerge as the starter. But Steve told us he thought Kenny Miles would play just as many snaps tonight as Brandon Wilds.
Kenny's best year a couple of seasons ago when he was over 600 yards rushing. Arkansas shows a possible blitz. They back out of it. Connor Shaw, quarterback draw, first down. Slides his way inside the 40. That's the element that number 14 gives you. He's not just a good runner. He's pretty shifty and pretty fast.
Yeah, he is, and he likes to run. He's not afraid to get hit. He knows when to get down. He's got a good feel for the quarterback run game, and that was called all the way. And a nice conversion on second and long. I'll tell you what, they need to give some help to their right tackle, though. Cody Gibson is not going to have a lot of success blocking against Jake Beckett if he doesn't get some help.
Gibson, a redshirt freshman, and Beckett has applied pressure all night long here in the first quarter. This time a little stunt in the middle that throws quick out to Wilds, and here's what he does very well. He's got nice body lean. And gets forward. He's a good size running back at 6'1 and 225 pounds, and he picks up the first down.
When the win over Tennessee a week ago, he had 28 carries for 137 yards. He was also their leading receiver with three catches for another 31 yards. So he really emerged last week for this offense.
Now they split out into an empty backfield. Wilds to the top of your screen, and the tight end on a slot. Here comes the blitz. Shaw with a flag down will be dropped by Jericho Nelson, the guy that came off the corner. Loss of a yard, but again, a penalty marker down.
I think with all the shifting of the backs out of the backfield onto the line, I don't know if they had enough guys on the line of scrimmage or if Arkansas was offside.
Offside. Number 92 of the defense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
It was the latter, DeQuinta Jones offside. So a couple of penalties have helped South Carolina on this drive.
Now here he is right here. He's listening to the quarterback, not watching the football, got a head start on the snap.
So first and five at the 24 of Arkansas. Oops, almost another offside. Jerry Franklin jumped in there and backed out.
See, that's the hard count. You do that on purpose to make the defense show their hand, and then once they show it, then they change the plays from the sideline.
Linebacker shifting around for the Hogs as Shaw fires near side, complete. Alshon Jeffery to the 20. Short of the first down, however, by about a yard. So second and short coming up, though.
The problem for Alshon Jeffery this year, he's still the leading receiver. That's his 34th catch of the year, but they haven't been able to get him the football down the field. Everything they've thrown to him, particularly Connor Shaw, has been short. And you look at the yards per reception difference between when Garcia was in and Shaw.
Wilds has got a first down. Only needed a yard, got two. And now South Carolina in the red zone, where they're kind of a strange situation for them. They don't have any field goals from the red zone, but they're doing great on touchdowns. They've scored 18 touchdowns in 25 trips into the red zone. As we look at that red zone, brought to you by Verizon. Kind of strange. Very good in the touchdown ratio, but not so good overall.
Yeah, and I kind of agree with Steve. I'd take the touchdowns over the higher percentage of scores. 1-7's better than 2-3's any day.
Yeah, Steve gave us that math lesson last night, by the way. Here comes a blitz. Shaw with a quick throw out to Jeffery. He's got a blocker in front, and he bowls his way down close to a first down inside the 10. And it took about four or five Razorbacks to bring him down after a pickup of 9.
Again, you know, Connor Shaw has done a good job of taking care of the football and not making careless throws, but this is the throw he's hit Alshon Jeffery with most of the time since he's been the starting quarterback. Quick wide receiver screens. Good idea to just get him the football, but now that you're inside the 15-yard line, I'd see if I can get a matchup and try to throw it up a jump ball type situation for him. He's such a big body, he's almost impossible to defend one-on-one.
Second down, and you can see about a foot to go for the first down.
I would take a shot at Alshon right now.
He's on the bottom of your screen.
He's working on Greg Gatz in number 28.
Play clock at 5. Shaw keeps it. Flags are down. I don't know if he got the first down either. No gain on the play. In fact, he might have lost a little bit.
Offsides. Number 61 of the defense. Penalty of taking half the distance to the goal. First down.
That is 3 penalties on Arkansas's defense on this drive that kept this thing going for South Carolina. And now they got a first and goal.
Yeah, this one, Zach Stadler, I think, just lined up offside. He didn't jump. He just lined up offside.
Just inside the 4-yard line. South Carolina trailing by a field goal, but threatening here.
And Alshon's got inside technique by the corner on him. Single coverage.
They'll toss it the other way to Wilds. Heading to the cone, and he got there. Touchdown, South Carolina. Brandon Wilds from 4 yards out. So the string of touchdowns when they get in the red zone continues, and they've got the lead.
Boy, really a nice block by Rory Anderson, number 81. Watch him seal on the inside. He got Jerry Franklin block, or I should say Alonzo Highsmith, and that was the key block to allow Wilds to get into the end zone. Justice Cunningham on the line of scrimmage, number 87, and Rory Anderson.
Wooten, the extra point, up and good. And so with 2:28 remaining in the first quarter, South Carolina has taken the lead. And Bobby Petrino, I know, is not happy about how that defense played on that series.
That's one thing to play with energy and play with enthusiasm, which we saw in the opening possession, but you can't allow that to create foolish mistakes.
Right.
And you can't help a team like South Carolina any more than they can do on their own.
Kick is going to go to Johnson at the 2-yard line. Dennis Johnson, one of the best in the country. Here he goes, and there he goes. Dennis Johnson, foot race. He'll win it. Touchdown, Arkansas. Did I tell you he was the conference leading active return man a little bit earlier? He just added 98 more to the total. Zach Hocker in for the point after. Right down the middle. Well, just when South Carolina had grabbed some momentum, Dennis Johnson took it all away.
Well, this is beautiful execution. These three guys right here, all three going to lead the way with excellent blocks. Number 15 is Keontae Miner, the guy who's in there for the suspended Marquell Wade, and he gets the last block. Dennis Johnson's got great speed. Nobody even laid a hand on him on that kickoff return. Outstanding execution by the Arkansas special team.
He had over 1,000 yards of kickoff return yardage a couple of seasons ago. And once you saw him hit that seam and get that one block from Miner, it was all over. Stephon Gilmore and Victor Hampton would like to do what Johnson just did as they await Zach Cocker's kickoff. Gonna have to run up on this one and take it on the fly at the 11. Hampton. And he slips and goes down on his own at about the 30-yard line. Let's check. Wilds behind Connor Shaw, the tailback, will get the call. And he's going to lose a yard on this one. Bring up second down and 11. In your case, it'll bring up second helpings, probably.
I wish.
You told me yesterday, best chicken
more.
Ever.
I've had a lot of good chicken. That was the best chicken I've had. This is the flavor. It was tender. It was crunchy. It was everything I would have hoped. It was the best I've ever had.
Mama did best.
Great place.
All right. You can follow Todd on Twitter at Taste of Town. Todd, by the way, as he continues his journey around some of the finest eateries in the United States. And in this case, in the SEC this week. And a nice open field tackle by Jericho Nelson after just 1 yard pickup. So not only did that kickoff return seem to ignite the fans here, kind of ignited the defense a little bit for Arkansas.
Well, it kind of bailed them out. You know, it wiped out the mistakes that they made. It got their team back in the lead. And again, you want them to play with passion and emotion. The last 2 weeks, playing at 11 o'clock kickoff times, they didn't play with great passion. They've got a little bit of that going tonight.
Crowd has been waiting for them to come home, and you can tell they're giving them a lot of support for the defense right now. Third and 10. Shaw's in trouble. Beckett has a hold of him. He got rid of the football incomplete, and they'll have to punt it away. Beckett came with some heat. He had some help from his friends back there. He's had a good first quarter.
Well, Beckett missed a few games with a hamstring injury, but it's not bothering him anymore. But he sure is bothering Cody Gibson, the right tackle. And the way you have to help him is either put a tight end next to him or have a back sit in there and chip a little bit to take some steam out of that end.
Scribner Howard with a punt. High kick. Fair catch, a late fair catch. He just got that arm up at the 24-yard line. Joe Adams, a 45-yard kick, no return. Tyler Wilson set to take the field with a three-point lead now. Holly?
Well, guys, after their last offensive possession, the Arkansas offense came over the sideline, and Coach Bobby Petrino came over and came unglued at his offensive line. And then, like any good parent, he came back again. He went back, yelled at him some more, and guys, he came back a third time, got right down in the face of their tight end. Three-time yelling. As a parent, I can relate to that.
All right, Holly. And there's a throw complete out to Dennis Johnson. So the good parenting is a three-yelling situation. Yeah. That's good. C.C. Whitlock, who's been a little bit banged up in recent weeks, guy that made the tackle that will bring the first quarter to a close. Biggest fireworks of the first quarter, 98-yard kickoff return for a touchdown by Dennis Johnson. That's what's given the Hogs the lead on their home field. End of one. Arkansas 10, South Carolina 7. Starting the second quarter with Arkansas in front. On a kickoff return for a touchdown. Second down and 13 to open the quarter. As Tyler Wilson rolls and throws late and out of bounds, and we got a flag down.
Still getting pressure.
Number 36 of the defense on a receiver. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
So the defense has a penalty on the other side. Here's Dennis Johnson. He is covered by Kelsey Quarles all over him. There's another freshman, this guy, defensive tackle. I tell you what, this defensive front of South Carolina is already good, and it's only going to get better.
Well, he was so quick off the ball. They're trying to cut him off with the center, and there was no way Travis Swanson was going to be able to pick him up because he was so quick in his first step, he was already past Swanson before he could do anything.
The freshman from Hodges, South Carolina, said it kind of kicked in the Georgia game. He was a little nervous in that because of the magnitude of the game, and he said, now I'm starting to just have fun and play football like I did in high school. And here's straight up the middle, Johnson for a first down, and then some. Wow. And at the end of the play, a head-on collision with Holloman, and Dennis won it.
One of the best ways to offset a good pass-rushing team, a team that likes to get up the field, is to run draws. You release your tight end down there on him. A nice job by Chris Gregg, number 80, getting a lead block. But you let those guys rush up the field, and you run the draw right past them.
Devontae Holloman's going to feel that hit for a while, I would guess. A 17-yard pickup. Now Ronnie Wingo checks into the Arkansas backfield. Wilson wants to throw back to the left. He's got a man wide open. Oh, and he dropped it at the 20-yard line. It would have been a touchdown to Wingo. They ran a wheel route for Wingo. They faked the handoff to him, and he was wide open.
Well, you run, then you go play action, and this was perfect. I mean, they had Wingo all by himself. Wingo just not able to catch the football.
He's about the best guy they got out of the backfield catching the ball, too. It just went right through his hands. Oh, he wants to just stay there right now. Roderick Green comes in. Wingo goes out. Second down at 10. Wilson, straight drop this time. Again, he's got to roll a little bit to throw, and he gets it out to Kobe Hamilton. About 2 yards shy of the first down. So Arkansas back in South Carolina territory. Short yardage coming up. Garrick McGee, the offensive coordinator there, right next to Coach Bobby Petrino.
Well, you got your big back in, and you got your big fullback in. Kiero Small, number 36, is a lead blocker.
They fake it, though, on third and short, and want to throw it. Wilson dancing around, lobs it, it's intercepted. This is South Carolina going the other way. Quarles. No, it's Taylor. Devin Taylor for a touchdown. Wilson was just trying to get rid of the ball, but Mick, number 98, was in the way.
Well, he should have just eaten the football. He wanted to throw to Kiero Small, number 36, but he gets knocked down. And so Tyler Wilson, instead of just taking the sack, tries to throw the ball away, but he's careless with the football, and South Carolina makes him pay for it.
First interception in 185 throws for Tyler Wilson, and it couldn't have been a worse one. 48-yard interception return for a touchdown, and that is what South Carolina has been doing all season long. This is a big-time mistake by number 8. A big, tall defensive end going the other way. Third lead change, South Carolina back in front. Tyler Wilson had gone so long without throwing an interception, and the one he threw was 6 points the other way for Devin Taylor. There's the string that ended. He got 185 on his ninth pass tonight that went 48 yards the other way.
Well, he was actually pretty lucky last week because he threw four or five that should have been picked off by Vanderbilt. They just dropped the football. This was just a bad decision on his part.
We've had an offensive touchdown, we've had a defensive touchdown, and we've had a special teams touchdown so far in the first half tonight. Very short kick and just stepping out of bounds at about the 32-yard line. Wilson reloads and goes long. Man there, got him. Jarius Wright, and he's gone. Wright, touchdown. This one could get crazy before it's over tonight.
I love that, though. I love Bobby Petrino, as mad as he was at Tyler Wilson for making the bonehead mistake. He comes right back and calls his number to make a big play throwing it down the field. I love that in a coach, and I love it in the quarterback.
First long play allowed by South Carolina of 40 or more yards all year. That one, 68 yards for the touchdown on the extra point. Gives us another lead change. Arkansas back in front, 17-14. Only took one play. Didn't take Jarius Wright very long after he hauled that pass in. And the Hogs back in front by three. If you like big plays, you've come to the right place, I guess.
I guess so.
We've had a couple of scoring plays that took roughly 15 seconds, including the last one. On a 68-yard touchdown pass, Tyler Wilson to Jarius Wright. Zach Hocker has been a busy kicker, both field goals and kickoffs. Gilmore and Hampton wait on the other end for South Carolina. 12:49 remaining in the first half. Line drive, tough catch, a yard deep by Hampton. And Hampton out across the 25 to about the 28-yard line. Now he gives off to Wilds. Only about two tough yards again for number 22. Wilds, a true freshman out of Blythewood, South Carolina. Had big numbers as a junior in high school, over 1,500 yards rushing, but not so much as a senior. Kind of under the radar, one of those three-star guys, I guess. Started the season basically, Steve Spurrier's at fifth on the depth chart at tailback. But because Marcus Lattimore out with a season-ending injury and some other injuries in the backfield, he's the guy carrying the ball for South Carolina now. This time they fake it to him, and Shaw on the run, looking to throw. And he's going to be run out of bounds by DeQuinta Jones on the far side.
Well, they got good pressure. Alonzo Highsmith was in there, and also a guy who just checked in, Colton Miles Nash, number 90, was a tight end until this week. He was a defensive end. He moved to offense. They moved him back to defense this week, and he's in there right now, and he was able to get a little pressure along with Alonzo Highsmith.
You could probably ask him what his number is, and he wouldn't even know. He was number six this time a week ago. And now Wilds joins him. The wide receiver out there with Jeffrey. So it's an empty backfield. Blitz on the way for Connor Shaw. Throws deep on the sideline on the run. It's almost intercepted by Isaac Madison. Scruggs was the intended receiver.
I'm not sure why Connor Shaw decided to go away from Alshon Jeffrey, because he had a perfect matchup. Him against a safety who was playing way off, and he was open. And I think it would have been an easier throw for Connor Shaw instead of trying to make this throw on the run down the field. They shifted the formation to get the matchup they wanted with Alshon, and Connor Shaw didn't throw him the football.
Saw the reaction of Steve Spurrier, and I think that was exactly what Todd was talking about. Scribner Howard with a punt. This one they're just going to have to get out of the way of. And it'll roll dead near the 25-yard line. Let's check in with Holly.
Well, guys, Alshon Jeffrey may not be 100% right now. I've seen him over here on the sideline on their training table getting massaged. They have a massage therapist on the trip with them, and his right quad just above his knee seems to be bothering him. I've watched him for a couple of plays. He's running on his route, and his gait just doesn't look normal. You saw Steve Spurrier just come over right now and ask him, hey, man, are you okay? He's trying to assure his coach he is, but you can just tell he's not at full speed tonight.
You know, when you're a guy that caught over 1,500 yards worth of passes at a school record 88 catches last year, it's got to be a little bit frustrating that he's not having those kinds of numbers this year. Dennis Johnson three or four tough yards for Johnson. Johnson's got a kickoff return for a touchdown tonight at 98 yards. We had a 68-yard pass play from Tyler Wilson to Jarius Wright. Those are the two biggest plays so far of the night. And again, in the pistol set, Tyler Wilson with a second down and six. Again, it's Johnson. Got a blocker in front. He's got the first down and more. Stiff arms his way into South Carolina territory. Swearinger ran him out of bounds, but he got 15 on that one.
Well, they pulled out a couple linemen, Travis Swanson, the center, and also Grant Freeman, the right tackle. Neither one of them gets overpowering blocks, but they just get in people's way enough to allow Dennis Johnson to get to the edge.
I was going to say, they took up some space at least out there.
They got some rug burns on the carpet, but they also got their back a first down.
At the 45-yard line, first and 10. Wilson throws in the middle and just throws that one to the ground.
Yeah, he learned his lesson. Yeah. They called a screen. It wasn't there. It was well diagnosed by South Carolina, and he threw the ball away.
They're trying to get it to Joe Adams in the middle, or he was the closest man at least. Live to play another down. Second down and 10. Just over 6 minutes remaining in the first half. Now they're overloaded to the left again. Wilson looks that way, throws a lazy pass intended for Greg. That could have been almost picked off. Tight end didn't get his head around on that ball. And Swearinger got close to coming in there and swooping that one up.
And now what you're going to see is South Carolina on third and long. They take their interior defensive tackles out, and they'll move Melvin Ingram inside. Number six goes in. They bring Clowney in the game. So they have their three defensive ends, their best pass rushers, on the field at the same time.
They call it their rabbit group. A lot of speed out there on the defensive front. Third and 10. Wilson in trouble in the pocket. And the Rabbits are chasing him, but they don't get him. But he doesn't get the first down either, as Ingram did track him down and knocks him down after he picked up 8 yards. Now the fans are screaming for Bobby Petrino to go for it here on what's going to be about a fourth and two.
That was great hustle play by Melvin Ingram. I mean, he couldn't get through the line of scrimmage. He had the center and guard both working on it, but he never gave up on the play and actually knocked the quarterback down short of the first down.
I don't think the crowd had any influence on Coach Petrino, but he is going to go for it on fourth down.
Little different formation now. Now they have a tight end in on the end of the line of scrimmage. So just three receivers, one tight end, one back.
South Carolina gets everybody up close here. As Wilson throws out of the flat to Johnson. He's got the first down. Down the sideline, he's got more than that. And so it was worth those timeouts. A 17-yard pass play out to Dennis Johnson, our impact player so far the night.
Well, you spread them out by formation. You shift your back into a route. And then the safety is late getting to him. And that's a long way for him to run to get to that running back coming out of the backfield. Shaq Wilson, the middle linebacker, couldn't catch up to him.
This is the 10th play of the drive. And it's at the 20-yard line. First down. Again, Tyler Wilson with Johnson behind him. And Johnson gets the carry straight ahead. Dives his way for about four. Late stages here in the second quarter. We're under 5 minutes. And the Hogs trying to add to their lead over South Carolina. South Carolina came in having won six straight road games on opponents' home fields. It's phrased that way because the SEC championship they didn't win. They didn't win the bowl game. But along the way, dating back to last year, they've been winning on other people's fields. Wilson throws on the run in the corner, incomplete. Joe Adams was out there. There was double coverage from Swearinger and Gilmore. And it'll bring up third down and six. Need to get to the 10-yard line for the first down.
Well, again, South Carolina counters with their rabbit package.
So you have Clowney and Devin Taylor rushing on the outside, and Melvin Ingram would move inside and rush over the left guard.
Wilson to the end zone, touchdown, Jarius Wright. Wright on the money. Wilson throws a second strike to number four on the evening.
Victor Hampton was the guy in coverage, and when we look at this, you're going to see him just give up inside position way too easily to a great receiver.
Zach Hocker in for another point after. It's up and good, and Jarius Wright has added touchdown receptions number 8 and 9 on the season. Right now, number 7 has got a 10-point lead on their home field, 24-14 as we check in.
Well, Coach, it looks like you made a change on your offensive line and moved A.J. Can over to the right side. But what else can you do to help protect Connor a little bit?
Well, obviously, we can't pass block well enough to throw the ball down the field, it appears. I think Connor could have thrown a few, but we got to try something different. We can't spread out and just throw the ball. We got to try something different. We're only 10 down, so we got to hopefully mix up the run and pass a little bit better.
How's Alshon Jeffrey, Coach?
Oh, he's fine. I can't get a ball going at him. He's running around out there. I wish we could get something just in the air at him.
Thanks, Coach.
Just about set to start the third quarter between Arkansas and South Carolina. I tell you what, 3 3-and-outs in 5 possessions, 49 yards of total offense. That's not going to get it done. We knew South Carolina was struggling on offense. But, you know, Todd, Steve said to Holly going to the locker room, I wish we could at least aim one at Alshon Jeffrey.
Well, 2 catches for 13 yards. They've only got 49 yards of total offense. And when you get situations where he's matched up in single coverage, you got to give him a shot. You got to go ahead and throw the football. Stick with him. He's got his man off on a little out route. And what happens is Connor Shaw gets off of him too quickly. You see him looking, and then right away he makes the decision to go somewhere else with the football. When you get the opportunity to throw to Alshon Jeffrey, you better give him a shot. I think the other thing South Carolina might need to do, they might need to get Bruce Ellington involved, maybe a little wildcat quarterback. They've got to find some way to generate some bigger plays on offense.
They will get the football first in the third quarter as Hocker's got it teed up. Stevon Gilmore and Victor Hampton are back deep. And here we go, second half. At the goal line is Hampton. Hampton's got a little bit of room to run. A lot of room to run for Hampton. He's all the way to midfield and into Arkansas territory, and Hocker, the kicker, had to bring him down.
All right, little trick formation. They did this a lot against Kentucky. You've got 2 offensive linemen out here. You only have 3 in here, and Alshon's down here by himself, isolated.
First offensive snap of the third quarter after the 55-yard kickoff return. It's Wilds, and Trey Flowers wasn't wild about that play. Nice job by the freshman, a loss of 3 on the tackle.
Yeah, you try to get him out of position with your formation, and Trey Flowers does a great job of fighting off the block of A.J. Can and making the stop.
So the trick formation ended up with a 2-yard loss.
I hope they didn't spend too much time at halftime drawing that one up.
I hope so, too. Shaw, deep middle, overshot everybody. Alshon Jeffrey was the intended receiver as we check in with Holly.
Well, guys, I caught up with Bobby Petrino at the half for Arkansas, and he was frustrated they couldn't score right before the half. He said, we just got to do a better job. But he does like how they've slowed down South Carolina's pass rush with their ability to run the football. He wants them to continue doing that in the second half. But you talked about getting Bruce Ellington for South Carolina involved, guys. They were examining his left knee before that half. I'm not sure how healthy he is. We'll see if he's able to go here in the second half.
All right, Holly, this is the third time, the fourth time that South Carolina's had it. Third down and 10 or longer. And here comes extra pressure on Shaw, who flares it out to Wilds. Got a blocker in front of him. And Wilds, did he get there? I think so.
Well, that's a great job by Alshon Jeffrey, because he was that blocker that you talked about. They put him out there. He drew double coverage. Nobody picked up the back underneath. Connor Shaw got him the football. And then watch Alshon Jeffrey just use that big body to knock his man back and get Wilds the first down.
Shaw on a slip screen, got it to Ellington in traffic, and he did his best to pick up 10 or 11.
I think we got 15 more for a personal foul, late hit on the quarterback as well. So South Carolina should be in excellent position here.
Remember, on South Carolina's opening touchdown drive, Arkansas's defensive penalties kept that whole drive alive for him. Could
personal
be helping
foul
here.
Roughing the passer. Number 91 of the defense. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Jake Beckett is going to get the call.
Jake Beckett had a great first half. Really put pressure on South Carolina, forced him to make some changes up front.
Oh.
And that's a bad hit. I mean,
yeah,
that's helmet to helmet. It's above the shoulders, and it's after the play.
It's about all the bad things you can come up with on one play. Seven penalties, five on the Arkansas defense. And it's first and goal for the Gamecocks. Two tight ends set. And now Wilds will shift to Connor Shaw's left side. Blitz is coming. The fade to the corner. Alshon Jeffery was the intended receiver.
He slipped. You know, it was underthrown intentionally, but Alshon Jeffery lost his footing, and therefore he wasn't able to go up high to catch the football. I mean, this is a good idea to throw a jump ball for him in the end zone and let him go up, but Alshon slipped, and he wasn't able to go up into the air and high point the ball, and that enabled Greg Gatson to make a play on it.
Second down, a goal. Shaw, quarterback draw all the way, and he is in. Touchdown, South Carolina. 9 yards for Connor Shaw, another rushing touchdown on the season. His second after having one a week ago. It all got helped out by a 55-yard kickoff return, so they didn't have to go that far. And then it was also helped by a personal foul and a 15-yard penalty. That set them up to end up a 45-yard drive and 9 plays. And South Carolina right back in the thick of this one. 24-21. South Carolina on their opening drive of the third quarter finds the Arkansas end zone. 3-point game. Connor Shaw, a 9-yard touchdown run, has closed the gap to 24-21. Arkansas in front.
Well, we talked about the toughness of Tyler Wilson in the first half of this game, the Arkansas quarterback. Connor Shaw showed a little toughness in that drive.
I guess. Jay Wooten will tee it up. Deontay Minor and Dennis Johnson are back deep. You want to keep it out of number 33's hands. If you're the kicker, he already took one 98 yards earlier in the ball game. He's been a huge part of the Arkansas offense and special teams tonight, number 33.
They already did a sky kick over to the right side. See what they do this time.
Going to try it again. Going to camp under this one and take it at the 15. That's Minor. And he got a pretty good return. Razorbacks from their own 34-yard line. And Wilson in an empty backfield. Throws to the left side of Kobe Hamilton. And he picks up about 6.
Run!
24-21 here is Dennis Johnson trying to spin his way to a first down. And he's only going to get a yard. Nice job by Swearinger and the Gamecock defense to force a third down here. Boy, if you score on your opening drive of the third quarter and then you get a stop on Arkansas on their opening possession, that's pretty good for the old ball coach and his team. But they have to stop at 3rd and 3 here to do so.
Arkansas loves the crossing routes. If they anticipate man coverage, 3rd down and medium like this play is.
Deep sideline, caught by Adams to the 20. Joe Adams and Wilson hook up this time for 39 yards.
Well, Swearinger was in coverage, but the safety Holloman fell down on his way to help. He was on his way over to help. Actually, it was Bryson Williams, number 11, who was coming over to help and tripped and wasn't able to get there.
Arkansas right back to the red zone again, and now it's Johnson time. Puts his head down and takes everybody with him almost 10 more yards. Boy, he is running hard tonight. The junior out of Texarkana, Arkansas. 72 on 13 rushes and a kickoff return touchdown.
He's a hard guy to tackle. He's built low to the ground, real big legs.
This time they don't get him short of the first down either. Three more, and it's first and goal. What a big, big third down play by Tyler Wilson and Joe Adams. And again, Hogs go without a huddle as they've got it just inside the South Carolina 8. First and goal, Arkansas. Wilson to the corner. Jarius Wright had his hands on it. I think the ball might have gotten tipped en route a little bit.
Well, I don't know. That looked like a pretty good throw. Jarius Wright, usually very sure-handed. Stephon Gilmore was in coverage.
Pretty close to the same kind of play they used for the two-point conversion against Vanderbilt last week in that same spot. Second down and goal. Johnson the single setback. They've got two tight ends in there, both on the right side. Quick drop, the slant. Almost picked off by Gilmore. Intended for Kobe Hamilton.
Both corners were playing off. A little bit of a different technique on the 10-yard line. Then they jump inside, and Gilmore jumped the route. I mean, he read the slant, jumped inside of it, and almost got an interception. So they were off on second down. Let's see if they're off or pressed on third down. Changing up the look.
Third down and goal. Wilson lobs it across the middle of Johnson, but he's going to be brought down at the 4-yard line. And let's see if the field goal unit Hocker is going to come on. That'll be the case.
That's a good defensive stand right there. They gave up some plays. They looked like they were back on their heels, and then they come through with three nice plays in a row to force the field goal attempt.
Hocker's missed a couple tonight. He had been very dependable. You talk about the big field goals against Vandy last week. He's missed a long one and one from 29. So this one should be a chip shot for Zach Hocker. And it is. So Arkansas answers, looking for seven, and they have to settle for three. 7:47 remaining. It's the SEC on ESPN, and we got a 6-point game in Fayetteville. Hocker, who hit the 21-yard field goal, set to kick away. Stephon Gilmore and Victor Hampton. Hampton, his return on the last one is what gave the Gamecocks the short field to work with and subsequently the touchdown. That got him to within three. Now it's a 6-point game. This is a deep kick, and it will not be returned. And Wild straight ahead, tough run. And the ball, did it come out at the end? There. Got two Razorbacks wrapped around it.
Well, I think they already ruled that he was down before the ball came out. Hard-nosed run, the zone play, good blocking on the inside. It's the center, T.J. Johnson, making his 36th career start, kind of blocking right in the middle of that play.
I'm not sure if I said that they were hoping for an Alabama win tonight. I meant LSU, if I misspoke. They already lost to Alabama, and they've got LSU in the final game of the regular season. We're talking about Arkansas. And now the ball is out, and this time Arkansas's got it. Bad exchange this time.
You're right. I don't know if Connor Shaw opened up the wrong way, if Brandon Wilds went the wrong way, but as a quarterback, you should never try to make this handoff late. Just take it yourself and run it back up where the play was designed. They never got a clean exchange. And Jerry Franklin was there to make sure the ball was coming out.
Mr. Dependable in his 46th start. Back-to-back weeks with a fumble recovery. Last week it was a 94-yard return for a score. This one sets up his offense at the South Carolina 38-yard line. And Broderick Green only got about a yard, maybe two. Franklin, Jerry Franklin, one of the defensive captains. Got over 350 career tackles, but this was the game saver against Vanderbilt last week. And then the two-point conversion toss to Jarius Wright. And then they had to hope and pray that Vandy was going to miss a short field goal. Guess what? They did. And Arkansas survived 31-28 in Nashville. That's why they have only one loss on the year. Here's Tyler Wilson throwing on the run, and he threw a strike to Adams. Nice spin by Adams.
Got the first down, but he stepped out of bounds right after the catch as he was trying to spin upfield. But first down nonetheless for Arkansas. Wilson, you know, the thing I like about him, one of the things I like about him as a quarterback, he can make throws from a lot of different body positions and arm angles. He doesn't have to be set up perfectly and step into the throw perfectly to make accurate throws.
Now first down, Arkansas at the 15. They fake the toss sweep to Johnson. Wilson's in trouble, and he's going to go down. Sacked by Devin Taylor.
You know, they tried to pick on Bryson Williams right there, and he did his job. He stayed in. They tried to get the running back out in the flat. Watch the bootleg fake. They're going to try to slip Ronnie Wingo out, but the safety, Bryson Williams, is right there, and Devin Taylor is able to come up with the sack.
First of the night for South Carolina. So it forces second down and 14 now as we're down near the 2-minute mark here in the third quarter. Arkansas by six. Jarius Wright in motion. Wilson throws. Had it right in his hands and dropped it. And that was Jarius Wright. And he's not going to drop too many. It's a fourth drop pass by Arkansas tonight.
Just simply a case of an excellent receiver trying to look to turn up field before he secured the catch.
And of those four, we know that one would have been a touchdown. Kobe Hamilton's. We assume Ronnie Wingo would have outrun everybody. He's a sprinter, and he had one. That one would have gotten the first down. Wilson fires this time. This is caught by Greg Childs, and his forward progress will have him down around the 8-yard line.
Well, I think Bobby Petrino's doing the right thing. You got to go for more points here. Right now, it's a one-possession game. If you make this field goal, you make it a two-possession game.
This will be about a 25-yard attempt by Hocker. Missed from 29 and 45, but he hit a 44 and a 21. Zach Hocker, as Todd said, try to make it a 9-point cushion in a 2-possession game, and he does. Field goal's good. So they turn Jerry Franklin's fumble recovery into 3 points. And by the way, a big basketball game on Veterans Day between Michigan State and North Carolina out on the aircraft carrier. That's going to be a scene.
Yeah, that will be.
That'll be cool. Zach Hocker. We mentioned earlier, a very busy kicker tonight. Gilmore and Hampton back deep. Arkansas trying to go to 8-1 and stay in the hunt in the BCS. South Carolina trying to repeat as SEC East champions, but in a 9-point hole right now. Hampton. And he's out to the 20. Here, 30-21. Arkansas, and the crowd making it tough on Connor Shaw at the 20-yard line. Shaw on first down to throw to Jeffrey, and he's got five or six.
See, now that time Connor Shaw stayed with Alshon. They had the same kind of situation. He's lined up in the slot. He has a safety over the top in coverage. One-on-one. Go ahead and give him a chance to make a play. It wasn't a long gain, but you stick with him. When he gets single coverage, give him a shot to make a play for you.
Remember the last touchdown drive for South Carolina? They almost went as far in total yardage as they did in the entire first half. They had 49 yards of offense at halftime. Throw complete out near a first down, maybe a little bit short. Nick Jones getting banged around by the Arkansas defenders, and he's maybe the length of the football short. And now I think wise thing to do is just bring the team over, let the clock expire, talk things over on the sideline, and head to the fourth quarter with number 7 Arkansas holding on to a 9-point lead over number 9 South Carolina here in Fayetteville. Tusk enjoying some grapes as we head to the fourth quarter. He's had about 40 grapes while we've been watching him. 30-21. His Hogs on the field, lead by 9. We've got third down and the tip of the football short of a first down to open up the quarter. Brad Nessler, Ty Blackledge, Holly Rowe, and our ESPN crew, Razorback Stadium on a sellout night at homecoming, about 50 degrees. Everybody enjoying the weekend festivities, and they'll really enjoy it and party through the night, I'm sure, if they maintain this lead and hold on to their 8th win of the year.
Last time South Carolina had a 3rd-and-1 on their scoring drive to open the second half, Connor Shaw went under center and they went quarterback sneak. He got it, but he took quite a shot to the head.
This time he'll be in the shotgun as he switches his tight end Cunningham over on the left side. He will throw for the first down and completes it. Wow. Didn't get much, but Ace Sanders got a yard or two.
We did a nice job of stepping up in the pocket. Arkansas came with pressure. He stepped up. He got the ball to Ace Sanders, and they didn't get much more than the first down, but they got what they needed. Again, no big plays for South Carolina tonight. Only 3 plays over 10 yards, but the longest play of the night, 12 yards for the Gamecocks.
I'm not sure how that pass didn't get batted down, but he got it to him somehow. And it's first down, South Carolina. Gamecocks at their own 32. Shaw fires complete. No, in and out of the hands of D'Angelo Smith. And now the dropsies have gone to the South Carolina side on the receiving corps.
The best ball that I've seen Connor Shaw throw tonight.
Yep.
I mean, he really stepped into this. Had a little wobble to it, but it was right on the mark. D'Angelo Smith let that thing get all the way to his body, and it bounced right off his shoulder pads.
Second down at 10. Ace Sanders in motion. Here comes a blitz. Shaw throws it to Sanders. He makes a move in the middle of the field and got out to the 39-yard line. Let's check in with Holly.
Well, guys, you might notice that a quarterback, Connor Shaw, is wearing a glove on his hand, on his throwing hand. Now, this is usually associated with wide receivers or defensive backs. Steve Spurrier says he loves it. It is so tacky. It helps him grip the ball better. Steve said, boy, if I had one of those when I was a quarterback, I would have worn it every play.
He already won a Heisman Trophy without a glove. I'm not sure why he needed one, but that's what he told us last night. That one on Holly is just a little bit too baggy for you, Hal. I think you need a little smaller glove.
They weren't tight on the fingers,
that's
for sure.
No, they weren't. No. But completion out to the 44 and a first down. South Carolina continues to move. So does the clock. We're down to 13 and a half to go. And it's a 2-possession game. South Carolina trailing by 9.
Ace Sanders comes on late. They only had 10 players out there, and Ace comes in with a new play.
And now they got an ace in the hole. He's on the slot to Shaw's right. Connor sets up and airs it deep. Got a man out there and overshot him. It was Demir Byrd, and he had a step back there on Madison.
I guess that shows you Connor Shaw's got a pretty strong arm.
He does have a strong arm, and they had to take a shot down the field. I mean, Steve called it thinking they were going to have it open to hit. They didn't hit it, but you got to try to stretch this Arkansas defense. Again, this is a defense coming in 10th in the SEC in total yards, 10th in rushing defense, 10th in passing defense, and yet they've really held your offense in check.
South Carolina, one timeout remaining. Second down and 10. Just over 13 to play here in Fayetteville. Shaw over the middle, completes it to his tight end. He got it to midfield, but it's still going to be third down at about 4.
Justice Cunningham, 13 catches coming into the ball game tonight. First time Connor Shaw has looked his way.
And now Ellington comes in as an extra receiver. On third down and 4 from midfield. Delayed blitz. Pass is complete. It's a first down to Kenny Miles. That's his first catch out of the backfield tonight.
Nice decision that time by Connor Shaw. He looked over the defense. He had a lot of options. He looked where he had a matchup where the corner was off and not pressed. And he threw the quick hitch for the first down.
That's the 7th different guy he's hit tonight.
Darius Winston was in coverage. He was off. Connor Shaw went to the right spot.
10th play of the Gamecock drive at the 43 of Arkansas. Shaw on an empty backfield. And as rally his troops down the field for a score here and got it to Miles again. And Kenny does his thing. Oh, bulls over Tremaine Thomas. And he got it all the way to the 20.
There's a flag down, but I think Jake Beckett was lined up offsides. I think South Carolina will decline this penalty and take the game.
Offside, number 91 of the defense. That penalty's declined. First down.
That's the call, and that's the declining of the penalty. And watch Kenny Miles take it 23 yards down the sideline and deliver a couple of hits of his own.
Well, the reason Kenny Miles was so open on the sideline is because two defenders went with Alshon Jeffrey. Even though he hasn't had a big night, he's still a big target. And Arkansas was respecting him, and that opened up things for Miles.
Connor Shaw, quarterback draw. Shaw got 7 before he's cut down by Thomas.
Well, you got Alshon Jeffrey, who's blocking again, and Kenny Miles, who just caught the ball. He's the lead blocker this time. Watch him get a nice block on Jerry Franklin. Jeffrey's blocking outside, and a nice game for Connor Shaw.
Shaw with a touchdown run of 9 yards tonight among his carries. Got 7 on that one, 2nd and 3. And now he'll keep it again, and he might score again. He's inside the 2 down to the 1-yard line. And it is 1st and goal, South Carolina.
Well, kind of hard to believe this offense only gained 49 yards in the first half.
Yeah.
And they've moved up and down the field here in the second half. A little bit of passing, but mostly running. Some of Connor Shaw, some of Bruce Ellington.
Kenny Miles, the single setback right now. It's Shaw, quarterback keeper. He's in, touchdown, South Carolina. His 2nd rushing touchdown of the night.
Yeah, Connor Shaw, I don't think he was in until Kenny Miles hit him in the back. Kenny Miles went diving into the pile, got into Shaw, and helped push him across the goal line.
You see the football crossing the goal line to cap an 80-yard drive and 13 plays. They needed that one.
They sure did.
Extra point is good. And only a field goal. The difference here, a 2-point game. 30-28, Arkansas trying to hold on to the SEC on ESPN. The most plays of any of our scoring drives tonight, just engineered by Connor Shaw. 13 plays, 80 yards. And his 2nd touchdown of the night. And now down to a 2-point game. And still a lot of time, 10 and a half to play. And his kick is going to go to Johnson at the five. Dennis Johnson, he gets to the corner, he might have another big one. Johnson across the 30, out to the 36. He was one guy away from getting around that left corner and taking this one 95 yards.
Well, that's the double-edged sword. If you kick short to kick away from them, you give them good field position. If you kick to them and you don't cover with discipline, you still give up good field position.
He got 32 on this one, but it could have been a lot bigger. It almost was. As it is, Arkansas with good field position at its 37-yard line. Play action. Tyler Wilson backpedals and throws it to the sideline. Is that a screen? They're trying to set up a screen.
Yeah, looks like
kind of funny looking.
Yep. Looks like they were, wasn't there. And ever since he made the mistake where he threw the ball when he shouldn't have thrown it, it ended up in an interception return for a touchdown. He's been very smart about throwing the football away when it's not there.
Wilson with a couple of touchdown passes to Jarius Wright, his favorite receiver tonight. That's what got him in the lead, and they haven't relinquished it yet. Down the middle, got it complete to the tight end, Chris Gregg. And it's a first down in South Carolina territory.
Well, this was the tight end working against Melvin Ingram, I believe, who had dropped into coverage. They brought pressure from the outside and dropped Ingram off in pass coverage, and he ended up trying to cover the tight end, and Tyler Wilson did a good job finding him.
Without a huddle, Wilson fires again. This one incomplete. Stephon Gilmore puts a big hit on Jarius Wright. Here, 30-28, Arkansas. And we're under 10 minutes. Here comes Dennis Green again. Another first down run. And now while they may go without a huddle, Todd, they don't want to just hurry up here. Wouldn't they want to use clock when they get these first downs?
Yeah, I think they want to use clock. But I also think that the hurry up and the no huddle is creating a little fatigue on the South Carolina defense. So you want to do that. Kind of play both sides of it.
And first and 10 after another tough run by our impact player of the night so far, Dennis Johnson. Blitz coming on Wilson. Throws Gregg again, the tight end, and he's near the 20.
Boy, he was wide open. This is a bust somewhere in the coverage. It was a blitz, and nobody stayed home for the tight end. Watch Gregg just run right into the voided area where the blitzing linebacker came from, and nobody picked him up quickly. Again, Holly just mentioned, Holloman out of the game. Antonio Allen out of the game.
Wilson on the throw, completes, and it's inside the 10 to Julian Horton. So it's going to be first and goal. Horton with his foot. Ooh, that was real close to being with his foot out of bounds, yeah, making the catch.
Now, Brandon Mitchell came in for one play last week against Vanderbilt, and it was a quarterback run for a touchdown. He's an outstanding runner.
And he's a load at 230 pounds. Gives it off to Ronnie Wingo, and Wingo's down to the four, maybe the three.
I wouldn't be surprised if they keep him in. They got a nice run that time, giving it to Wingo. You've got the option of the quarterback keeping it here. And you gain an extra blocker when your quarterback runs the football. Plus, Mitchell's a big guy. He's 6'4", 230 pounds.
Arkansas's had four possessions in the red zone tonight. They got a touchdown, a couple of field goals, and missed a field goal. They don't want to miss an opportunity here on second and goal. Wingo is in. Touchdown, Arkansas. That's a big one.
Well, they went unbalanced line. You've got two offensive tackles to the right. They run that way. They bring Chris Gregg in kind of as a trap block. And then Wingo powers it into the end zone. Run behind your big guys. Your tight end gets a nice kick out block.
And Hocker's extra point is good. So it didn't take long on the scoring drive. Never had a third down on the drive either. And Ronnie Wingo's third rushing touchdown of the year has got the Hogs in business with 8:09 to play. So that's a two-possession situation with time running out on South Carolina.
You know, take a look at this touchdown again. Again, Brandon Mitchell's in the game. When Wingo gets the ball, he almost fumbles it right there. And before the hit by Rodney Paulk, he's able to secure the football and get it in the end zone. Remember last week against Vanderbilt, it was a fumble by Vanderbilt on the 4-yard line that was returned for a touchdown by Jerry Franklin that turned the game for Arkansas.
Nice use of the backs tonight by Arkansas. Dennis Johnson's done most of the damage, but Ronnie Wingo's been in there at times, Broderick Green at times. And now South Carolina knows what they're up against with 8 minutes to play. And Arkansas, nice job by Ross Rassner on the kick coverage. It's getting tougher on every snap for the Gamecocks. Here comes Beckett. Down goes Shaw. The ball is out. Arkansas's got it at the 1-foot line. Jake Beckett again. He's been a thorn in Connor Shaw's backside all night. And Connor Shaw is still on his backside after that hit.
Well, there was a tight end on that side, and Beckett got a good jump, and A.J. Cann was slow coming out of his stance because of the tight end being there and didn't get a good push on him at all. Beckett coming from the blind side, perfectly timed hit.
Beckett's had as good a game as any defensive end we've probably seen this year. And it almost resulted in a touchdown as DeQuinta Jones diving on the ball, but they spotted the one. Another look at a vicious hit on the South Carolina quarterback. And the football is at the 1-foot line. He will try it again. Oh, and he's pulled back by his helmet. The ball never got there. Rodney Paulk, tough looking tackle. Gonna have a lot of guys who are gonna have stiff necks tomorrow. Tyler might want to hand this to a tailback this next time.
Nice goal line stand so far for South Carolina. The only problem is that clock continues to run. You've got to score twice as it is. If they score again, you're going to have to score 3 times.
Second down, inches to go. It will be a tailback. Broderick Green bulls his way in what should be the capper for the Razorbacks. Team that's been talking about just not playing well in recent weeks, though they've survived and won and advanced. And Arkansas tonight, you take away that interception return for a touchdown, and they're starting to hit on their cylinders on top.
They felt when we were here before for the Auburn game, that was the best they had played, and I think they looked even better tonight.
Me too. Just over 4 minutes to go. Seems impossible that South Carolina is going to continue how well they played on the road, because right now the hometown Hogs are in command, 44-28. Connor Shaw on the sideline with 4:07 remaining. They're still checking to see if he's okay. That's Dylan Thompson, the backup, and again the hit, Jake Beckett, part of his 2 sack nights. This one blasting the South Carolina quarterback, led to the touchdown and thus a 16-point lead. Theoretically it's a 2-possession game, but that would have to take into account a couple of South Carolina touchdowns and 2 two-point conversions, and in a hurry. The kicker has got it.
stopped and trying to make a play, carrying the ball pretty loosely, and the ball gets ripped out. I mean, he did not have the ball very well protected away from his body. The ball comes out. DeAnthony Curtis, one of the guys down there to make the hit.
Arkansas tonight, 4 takeaways, a season high, 5 sacks, a season high. And all of South Carolina's turnovers have come on their end of the field. And now Arkansas doesn't need any more points. They just need the clock to go. Alshon Jeffery can only look on. Another relatively quiet night for him. And for Bobby Petrino, another 8-1 record, 4-0 at home, 4-1 in the SEC. Their only loss to Alabama.
Yep.
So they'll be looking at the scoreboard in the locker room and wondering whether or not LSU can beat Alabama. And then they've got their own shot at LSU on the road at the end of the season. You wonder where the BCS folks will have Arkansas after this game. We'll find out tomorrow night. But they're certainly not going backwards. We know that much.
Yeah. And, you know, we talked about this defense of South Carolina, the high rankings, and I think they are an outstanding defense. But we also said they hadn't played an offense as good as this Arkansas offense. I mean, consider this. In the last 6 games coming into tonight, they'd only allowed 58 points. And Arkansas has put 44 up on the board on them tonight.
Tennessee game is here. Mississippi State game is in Little Rock and then at LSU. And they're going to be favored in the first 2 of those. And who knows, last year they made the Sugar Bowl against Ohio State by not playing in the SEC championship game. And right now the folks in Athens and around the state of Georgia are hooting and hollering and barking because Georgia now controls the East if they win out, because South Carolina is going to drop their 2nd game in conference play. Georgia was out of conference today and had a big win. But they've got Auburn coming up next in Athens. South Carolina came in hoping to defend their SEC East crown. Now that crown is wobbling right now. We're down to 1:20 in what might be Arkansas's best performance of the season. And they're showing the South Carolina defense isn't quitting. Rodney Paulk, nice stop on the tailback. Dylan Thompson is in at quarterback for South Carolina, so Connor Shaw's night is done. South Carolina's night's going to be done in the next 68 seconds. Arkansas tonight got into South Carolina territory on every one of their possessions. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Holly, is Connor Shaw okay?
Well, guys, they've been evaluating him for headaches, which is never a good sign if that's concussion symptoms. They would not let him return to this game. It's a big deal because they host Florida next week, and Thompson is a redshirt freshman who's thrown exactly 2 passes in his career.
Man, oh, man. Jerry Franklin makes a stop on Eric Baker, and might be down to 1 more play.
I think this is the most consistent that the Arkansas defense has played against a quality opponent this year. I mean, they didn't have the breakdowns that they've had in other games. And you know what their offense can do is they get that running game going, they just get better and better.
Thompson gets the first down on the quarterback draw. Bobby Petrino and Willie Robinson, the offense and the defense shaking hands. Big, big win. First time Bobby Petrino's ever been off to a 7-1 start. Now he's off to an 8-1 start. And South Carolina drops to 7-2. And they've lost their 2nd game in the SEC, giving Georgia the dog door opening that they need. Good ball game. And Holly's with a winning coach.
Coach Petrino, Steve Spurrier just told you you've got a pretty good team. How did you like the way your team started out tonight?
Well, we started a lot better than we have, and our guys really competed hard. I like the way our defense played. Offense kept moving the ball, and critical points of the game we're able to score.
turnovers were a big deal too, forcing turnovers.
Yeah, that's something we've been waiting on to happen, and we took care of the ball and they turned it over.
I know a lot of eyes are on a game down south right now, but how does this set you up to possibly win out and make some noise in the SEC?
Well, all we need to do is worry about next week. Tennessee coming in here, we just got to get ready to play and come out and play well.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Good football team they got here in Fayetteville. Good defensive end who had a huge night, Jake Beckett. 44-28 is the final score. Sports Center is coming up next. It's going to wrap it up for us. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Todd Blackledge, Holly Rowe, our entire crew, Brad Nessler, saying good night from Fayetteville, Arkansas, where the Hogs win it 44-28.